Wow.
Yeah.
The rain, the wind, the lightning, the thunder. We saw it all again tonight.
I've never heard the newsroom so loud with phones constantly ringing. I mean, literally, it was a constant ring from 6:30 all the way until now.
A lot of people stranded on the interstate were calling us trying to figure out what was going to happen.
And what they could do, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, and speaking of stranded, check out this video. We showed it to you earlier, but it's incredible stuff. And this is from Aaron Hilf. This was on Central. And you know that Central area where it goes under the rail runner and the railway there? Well, firefighters, as you see there, they had to help this person, rescue this person out of their vehicle because of nearly 4 feet of water at times. As they drove in, the car stalled. You see the lights go out. You'd never, ever want to drive into water-covered roads, folks. We can't stress that enough. You don't even know if the road's there, for one. But fortunately, that ended up safe. That person got out safely. The zoo is closed tomorrow. We just got that report in, by the way, and getting reports constantly. So basically, at 7:30 this evening, this is what happened, folks. This storm rapidly developed over the metro as outflows from the north worked in. And this is what we call a wet microburst. Likely, that's the meteorological term that will label this event. And it's a down burst that's accompanied by very heavy rain. The drag of that rain to the surface spreads out, hits the ground, and causes winds 89 mile per hour wind gusts. Hurricane force winds are 74 miles per hour, 15 better than that, with the 89 mile per hour wind gusts that caused all the damage that we're hearing about, the power poles down along I-25 down to the south. And this is a loop over that hour. You see the heavy rains that continue to cross the area and some impressive rainfall totals. Much of the rain is wrapping up for now, but check out these rainfall totals around the city. Close to 2 inches, 1.82 up toward the Rio Rancho Corrales area, 1.5 inches up around Placitas, 1.16 here at the station. The Sunport never gets rain, right? 1 1/3 inches at the Sunport as of the latest report. And we continue with rain along I-25. You can't get there because it's closed south of Albuquerque, but in the south side of Albuquerque. Los Lunas, Belen, down towards Socorro. And the southern and southwestern parts of the state hit hard earlier, beginning to quiet down. You can see Silver City, 0.78 of an inch of rain there. So more rain is likely going to be working through the state overnight. By 8 o'clock in the morning, could have some lingering showers across the south and southwest. As we go into tomorrow, we'll see another crop of showers and thunderstorms. Depending upon when the cloud cover breaks up, the cloud cover from the overnight hours, that will determine how many storms we have. And we could see that linger into tomorrow night, another wave of showers and thunderstorms. This time, maybe eastern areas of the state getting in on the action. And Sunday could be another active day for areas of New Mexico as well. Farmington, the Four Corners, scattered showers and thunderstorms tomorrow. Locally heavy rain is possible. Can't stress it enough. Always avoid arroyos, ditches, and water-covered roads. Southwest New Mexico, same situation. Watch out for heavy downpours. Maybe a little bit less active for you on Sunday. Southeast New Mexico, not very active tomorrow, but tomorrow night into Sunday, Carlsbad, Roswell, Hobbs could get in on the action. Around Raton, Red River, Towson, Las Vegas, scattered showers and thunderstorms. Locally heavy rainfall is possible tomorrow and also for Sunday. Santa Fe, we're looking at the chance of showers and thunderstorms. Could have some locally heavy rainfall tomorrow. Avoid all those arroyos, and if you hear thunder, take cover. That means get inside. Bernalillo, Rio Rancho Corrales, Las Lunas, and Blim. Well, you know, the atmosphere is kind of like a muscle. It's been overworked today and overnight during the nighttime hours tonight, so it may not be as active tomorrow afternoon, but keep it tuned here for updates because we do have a chance with all the moisture in the air of more scattered showers and thunderstorms, and I think it'll begin to get less active as we go into Monday and Tuesday roll. But this is just an incredible storm of historic proportions, and you know, the reports of damaged, flooded roads and closed roads, and I think I heard of even on the scanner at time that Zuni and San Pedro, there was a possible building collapse.
Wow.
Just we're going to have all this stuff
dealing with
in
a flooded basement too.
Yeah, so it's just a good idea to stay inside, folks, and let the emergency crews do their stuff.
Yeah. Okay.